This is Guardian Radio 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas. This is Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours.
It overflows. See that I think I've been back to school. Welcome to Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. You know my voice already. It's Levin Miller. Thank you so much for joining me. Thank you so much. From the tutelage of Charles W. Sanders, it is quite possible you are at the Salem Union Baptist Church at this present moment. I see they started the service promptly at 11. I mean, he would just love it exactly that way, right? I saw at 10:57. The color party was marching in, and I said it's because even in death, Rev wouldn't be late. Isn't that amazing? That is something amazing. And so you could listen to my show, and then right after you finish listening to me, you could tune into ZNS and watch the homegoing service, state funeral, state recognized funeral for the late Reverend Dr. Charles W. Sanders. And I'm going to be on my way over there immediately following this show. Because I got to go, right? I got to go. I got on a suit today, y'all. They make me put on a suit because I swore that I don't wear suits no more. I just put on t-shirt, pants, and loafers. I wear that every day. Mm-hmm. And but there's no way I would be caught there going into Salem on the day that Charles Sanders was to be buried in anything other than a suit. And so that's what I'll be doing today. But in the meantime, let me give you my phone numbers. Why? Because I given away free things. And this free thing cycle can't end. It can't, there's nobody on talk radio more benevolent than Levin, right? Because I care about y'all. I'm happy that y'all show up here every day for me. And so I want to prove to y'all how happy I am. And because I am so gracious, and I got big time friends, right? Because you couldn't do it without big time friends. I'm allowed to give away wonderful free things on air. And you all are allowed to win those things and be a part of my giving away of things, right? So my phone numbers are 323-6232, 325-4316. 3254259. I'm learning to say this number slower because my mommy tell me I gotta say it slower, right? My mommy said, I can't ever catch the number. So mommy, if you're listening, 323-6232, 4316325, 4259. I said it slow enough so my mommy could get it. And also, let me also say, I saw that E.R. Hanna has, right? Like, that man is a legend. E.R. Hanna, I met him shortly after the Hurricane Matthew. Of course, I was in another incarnation of my life where I was pretending to be a politician at some point. Of course, he lived outside of my constituency, but the part of the southern area that he lives in as a boy, I played a lot in. And because I knew of the travesty that had been visited by the after Hurricane Matthew, I went in the back there because I had started this thing during my candidacy where I wanted to hand out a chlorine tablet. A lot of the southern region of this island are on well supply. And it's because in the early 90s, if you lived in South Beach, you knew that if you got home anytime after 9 or 1 p.m., you couldn't bathe because the water would be off. And so many of the houses in that area are on well supply. And so I did a little bit of study, and I found out that one of the best ways to deal with water contamination, particularly after storms like Matthew, is through chlorination and filtration. And so I wanted to make sure that everybody was able to outfit their wells with ample chlorine and have the filters in there, so filter systems changed. And I ended up running into Mr. E.R. Hanna then, who told me, that's enough of that campaigning for the day. Come sit down. And I mean, he just walked me through a wonderful time that he's had and all the things that he's built. And he was such an amazing storytelling guy, right? I actually stole something from him when I asked him. I said, well, Mr. Hanna, how old are you? He said, well, boy, at my age, I stopped counting. What I do know for sure is I'm just as old as my tongue and slightly older than my teeth. And I've kept that with me ever since. It's actually one of those things that is, when you think about it, it's actually pretty true, right? Just as old as my tongue, slightly older than my teeth. And so Mr. E.R. Hanna has gone on to the great beyond. For all of you who knew about him or were unaware, I think it is fair enough for me to confirm now. I think I've seen it from enough legitimate sources that E.R. Hanna has departed. Also, I got to send a special shout out to one Nikki Forbes down there at the Ministry of Works on her birthday, right? And that's from her big time husband. Listen, her husband is the biggest time, big time dude in all of insurance sales, right? If you need insurance, you go see Big O. Don't go nowhere. If you don't know what to do, go see Big O. And once you go see Big O, I assure you, you got nowhere to go. Big O is gonna, he should pay me for this ad. Big O is gonna take care of all your insurance needs. He has everything you need more. He's your one-stop stopping insurance store. And he wants to say happy birthday to his wife. I think she turns 21, I think it is, 21, 51, something like that. But either way, he wanted to make sure I send that shout out to her down there at the Ministry of Work. So to Ms. Forbes, your husband, the best guy I know in insurance, wants to say happy birthday to you. That's enough of that, though. My number is 323-6232-325-4316, 325-4259. I've got one of my favorite people in the studio, y'all. Like, when I was growing up as a boy, my daddy would say things to me that didn't make sense at the time. And he would hail people because my daddy had me when he was 21. So all of my life, my daddy was a relatively young man in my eye. And he would say things like, you see this guy here? Man, I've known him for 30 years. And I would think to myself, that had to be impossible, daddy, 30 years. Because 30 years at the time, to a six-year-old, sounded like the world should have ended. And he'd say, yeah, man, I know this guy from we were in primary school. And I was like, but Jesus, my daddy's been in the primary school for when dragons existed, right? Mm-hmm. And I guess now I'm at the point in my life where there are some guys that are knocking around this place that I've known for 30 years. And Andretti Bain happens to be one of them. He's one of my favorite people. I promise him one of these days, I don't know through what power, maybe cosmosis, I'm going to see that he's my minister of sports in this country. I promise him that, right? And I'm saying my minister of sport, I don't know, maybe I'll be prime minister. Maybe I will be the whisperer to the prime minister, right?
You have to start playing politician again.
But at some point, I imagine I will play politician again. And hopefully, maybe the people will play voting electorate in my favor this time. They didn't play that the last time, right?
Okay.
So he's here with me in studio. And of course, if you know him, all of his life has been about, let's see if we can get his mic together. All of his life has been about athleticism and track. And I don't know this man to have done anything else in his entire life other than track and field. And he's been to the Olympics. So he's seen competition at the highest level, athleticism at the highest level. And while I know you all want to talk about Kay Forbes-Smith and the $400,000 and Heather Hunt and the $300,000 and all these other people with loan hundreds of thousands of dollars, I don't want to talk about that. I want to talk about y'all staying healthy and fit. Right. And I brought the guy that I think could get it done, and he is going to give away some free sessions.
Absolutely correct.
He's going to give away some free sessions. And so let's talk to him a little bit. Go get your pen. You know how y'all like to cheat and write it down? This is a good time now. Write it down. Because I don't know how much more of these it can happen, all right? So, Andretti, tell us a little bit about what's going on with you. How have you been? It's been a while. What's up?
Firstly, Levon, thank you for having me on your show again.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's truly a pleasure and an honor. And yes, you are one of the persons that I could say that I've known for over 30 years.
30 years, yeah.
Yeah, so and you've always been a stand-up guy.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm extremely proud of your journey. And I keep joking that you will one day be the future prime minister.
And you, my future minister of sports. Well, so when you all see it happen, don't play crazy. We've been planning this for 30 years.
I accept that.
All right, good.
I accept that. Man, Levon, I've been doing well. Really just building the Andretti Bean health and fitness brand,
mm-hmm.
Which is a spinoff of the Bahamian Dream Sports and Lifestyle Nutrition.
Okay.
And so actively involved in youth development, youth health and fitness,
mm-hmm.
And doing my part to try and encourage Bahamians to live a healthier and fitter life.
Okay. So you know, I know you have competed at an international level. Is what you're doing these days more geared toward the journey of competition, or are you now in the arena of mentorship and coaching?
I'm transitioning now into the arena of mentorship and coaching.
Mm-hmm.
I suffered a very severe Achilles injury about 2017,
mm-hmm.
and most doctors assumed that it was a career-ending injury.
Mm-hmm.
And I've been away from competition now since then, and the Achilles is starting to feel good again.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, I'm getting that urge to get back on the track.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I'm considered a veteran,
mm-hmm.
an older guy, you know. But for me, I love track and field. I've always loved track and field.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I joke all the time. From primary school days, when you guys saying you wanted to be doctors and lawyers and
yeah.
policemen and you know, what's not, I always said I wanted to run.
Dreddy wanted to be a track star.
I wanted to run.
We joked about that a lot in primary school.
Correct. And yeah. in high school, I got teased a lot
yeah.
about it too.
Yeah.
Right? But it was always a dream and a goal of mine. And, you know, I've been able to live that dream and live that goal.
Mm-hmm.
And my life's mission right now is to encourage others to do the same, thing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, dream big, work hard, have faith. And so, you know, secretly I'm still working out.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
You know, if one day I feel like I could get yeah. to that world-class level yeah, yeah, and I'm back on yeah, the track, then I'd love to do it.
Okay.
If not, I'll just have to go into the Masters League and try and compete with some of the older fellas, you know.
Yeah.
But I enjoy running. I enjoy working out. I enjoy pushing myself, trying to go beyond whatever my perceived limits may be.
Mm.
You know, I enjoy that. And while I'm doing that, I realized that I have so much to give back. And I love the coaching.
Mm-hmm.
I absolutely love it. I love mentoring, especially younger kids. And I tell them all the time, dream big. You would be surprised at what you could achieve.
Mm-hmm.
If I had known then that I was able to, that I would be able to achieve the things that I did,
mm-hmm.
later on I was going to dream even bigger.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, you have been to the pinnacle, like you've been to the Olympics, right? Like that is you know, that is the coup de grace. It's there are not very many things beyond that, right? And so when you say to me, you know, if you knew what you could have accomplished, you would have dreamed bigger. To people out there listening, they may be confused. Like where else could you have taken this?
So as a kid, my dream was to make it to the Olympics.
Mm-hmm.
And then throughout my career, you know, I've achieved Carifta medals. One of my most prized possessions came with being a two-time NCAA champion.
Mm-hmm.
So to put that into perspective, I was at one point the best mm-hmm. in the world in all collegiate systems,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
you know?
Mm-hmm.
And then going off to win an Olympic medal.
Right.
And I honestly felt like I should have had at least two Olympic medals, an individual medal in that same Olympics.
Mm-hmm.
And so it was, for me, it was about getting to the Olympics.
Mm-hmm.
Another thing that inspired me, that motivated me, that I dreamt about was the Airport Hall of Fame.
Okay.
You know, the Wall
yeah,
of
yeah,
Fame.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I always said, okay, I need to make it to the Olympics.
Yeah, yeah. And then get on the wall.
And then I'll get on the wall.
Yeah, yeah,
right?
Yeah.
And then after making it to the Olympics, after winning an Olympic medal, then I started to think, what if I had dreamt about being the world record holder?
Yeah.
You know, what if that was my belief? You know, how much further would I have gone? And so, you know, you hear the sky is the limit, and it's so cliche, but it's the truth. You know, the sky is the limit. You can achieve whatever you set out to go after.
And most of your accomplishments came as what would be considered a relatively young man. Because, I mean, you would have been about 20...
22, 23.
Yeah. And I look back at my life now, right? Like, because, you know, I've gone through several incarnations in my life. Like, at one time, I was playing soldier. And I did that around 19, 20, 21. There is somebody that I always admire, right? And I tell him it all the time, Travis Robinson, right? And I tell him all the time, I said, Travis, you know, if someone had told me that I could convince Bahamians that I was old enough and polished enough to serve in their parliament, there is no way I would have gone in the military at my age. Now, needless to say, I've never really wanted to be a politician. That people find it very difficult to believe. My friends all believe that. But I don't know if I would have, because I went to the military very specifically for the purpose of I wasn't interested in college,
right.
And I read up on you know, progressions through life that would lead to success. And the military is almost an automatic way, right? And so I went to the military. I was busy running up and down and playing in the bush at 23. I wouldn't do that anymore with my life, right? But here you are now saying 15 years up the road that, you know, something, I'm still interested in running and still interested in competing and still interested in possibly being on the world stage again. And that is amazing, because the success had happened so early that you actually have time now after your success to come out here as a very young man and give back and pour into. And so the point I'm trying to make is there are so many opportunities available in the sporting arena that allows you to have your life, because a lot of the other roads you will take, whether you go down the road of finance or politics or medicine, you literally have to go down that road for about 45 years, sometimes 50 years. When you're done, the only thing you want to do is sit on a back porch somewhere and drink some Chardonnay, maybe.
Right.
But going down the road you went, which is athleticism and the Olympics, et cetera, now at 37 years old, you're saying, man, I just want to give back. I want to. And that is amazing. I don't think that is a message that we get out there enough to young people, that there are ways for you to have a full, promising and successful career and leave that career at the height or as near to the top as possible with enough youthfulness left in you that you can come back and contribute. I tell people all the time, wisdom is something that you use your youth to pay for, only to get wisdom and not have enough youthfulness to use it, right?
Absolutely correct.
Yeah, that is amazing. And so I'm very happy about that. So if you're just tuning in, I'm talking to Andretti Bain. Why? He's one of my favorite people. Why? Because, I mean, the guy is probably one of the most consistent guys I know. I, if somebody ever said a bad word about him, I know that they was lying. And he's been all the way to the Olympics, and he's here with me because we want to give away free things today about his training program. So he's done the Bahamian Dream. It's now what, the Andretti Bain
Health and Fitness experiences.
What's different between the two?
Well, now that I started to transition a little bit more away from frontline competition and started to just put a little bit more into mentoring and coaching, I also saw the need for more of a global reach.
Okay.
And so I started to get a lot of clients who are outside of the Bahamas.
Really?
Yes. And so for me, they recognize the name Andretti Bain a whole lot more than the Bahamian Dream.
Yeah.
Right? And the health aspect is, it stems from the nutrition store, my online nutrition store, which is on AndrettiBain.com. The fitness aspect deals with the personal training, coaching, youth performance coaching, what's not. And now the experience came about through the pandemic.
Okay.
So in the midst of the pandemic, I got an opportunity to start hosting virtual experiences.
Okay.
And those virtual experiences entail fitness sessions, but more so motivational sessions, motivational seminars, not just for individuals, but for companies and corporations throughout the world. And so there's I realized that more persons are interested in hearing or hearing my story mm-hmm. than I actually thought.
Wow.
You know, and I have experienced this throughout my entire life. I've been places where somebody would come up to me and say, hey, I'm from this part of Africa, I'm from this part of Europe, and I watched you and that inspired me. And, that totally blew my mind. You know, stuff like that totally blew my mind. You know, I would get emails coming through social media, and in some cases through my mailbox. Hey, Andretti, this is a picture I got of you years ago in this country. Could you please sign it? This stuff, whatever, like that.
Mm-hmm.
And so having the opportunity to share my life's journey, and I call it my dream big, work hard, have faith story,
mm-hmm.
you know, I saw that there's a demand for that.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, I decided to transition more into the Andretti being health, fitness, and experiences because that encompasses everything that I'm doing now.
Hmm. Sound like you got a book or two inside there. You sound like you're about to start penning books. That's what it's beginning to
eventually,
sound like.
Once I could find the time.
Okay.
And truth be told.
Or you could just pay a writer.
That's true. I could have you do that, right?
Yeah, you could just pay a writer.
Correct.
Yeah.
I could have you do that,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
Yeah.
But honestly, I still feel as if my story is still being written.
Okay.
And I honestly feel as if I have so much more to accomplish, so much more to achieve, so much more to do, so much more to give back, that for me to write a book now, I may have to do a part two or part three and all that stuff like that. So, you know, I'm waiting, I'm compiling all the stories, compiling the content, but eventually I intend to do something like that. And but right now I still feel like the story is being written.
So give us your records. You were 2 times NCAA champion.
Correct.
4x1 silver medalist. 4x4 silver
Olympic
medalist.
Olympic Games silver medalist.
Mm-hmm.
Pan American Games gold medalist.
Mm-hmm.
Commonwealth Games silver medalist.
Mm-hmm.
Multiple regional CAC medalist. 2-time NCAA Division I champion. Multiple time NCAA All American. Carifta medalist. And also, what a lot of people probably don't know is because they see me in tennis and shoes all the time. I also have a bachelor's degree in business management,
mm-hmm.
a master's degree in business administration,
mm-hmm.
and partway through a PhD in education. So it wasn't just all track. I used track to kind of get some of these things.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
And but track has blessed me. Track has afforded me the life that I live in
mm-hmm.
terms of just being able to live by my own rules,
mm-hmm.
right? To be able to give back and to be an inspiration to others, to travel the world,
mm-hmm.
To touch others. So, you know.
So, okay. What was the gold shovel for? Because I remember you got the gold shovel. We took a picture. I took a picture with the gold shovel, y'all. It was big. It was gold. The whole thing was gold. Tell us about the accomplishment of the Gold Shovel Award. What was that?
Okay. So, a quick story.
Mm-hmm.
When I accepted the scholarship to Oral Roberts University, Oral Roberts University wasn't known for athletics.
Mm-hmm.
Oral Roberts University was known for creating pastors, you know, Dr. Miles Monroe,
right,
Dr.
Right.
Dave Burrows,
right.
The former Minister of Health, Renwood Wells. These persons went to ORU, right?
Mm-hmm.
Manel McKinsey, so on and so on. And so I went there and I told the coach, my goal is to become an Olympian. My goal is to become NCAA champion. Never has been done at the university.
Mm-hmm.
And through speaking that and achieving that, I was awarded one of the top 50 most distinguished persons in my university's history.
Mm-hmm.
And so the golden shovel was to commemorate my achievement as one of the groundbreakers, one of the torchbearers
mm-hmm.
for Oral Roberts University.
And that is with people of the likes of
Dr. Miles Monroe. Correct.
Yeah, that was really big.
Correct.
All right, 3236232325 4316325429. Those are my numbers. You can give me a call. Andretti Bean is in studio with me. You can text me 4224796 if you got your fitness questions. Let's talk a little bit now about your day-to-day training now.
Yes.
What are some of the things, products, and services you offer right now?
So I have an online nutrition store.
Mm-hmm.
And so I sell weight loss products, meal replacement proteins, vitamins, supplements, anything that you could think about that could help to supplement,
mm-hmm.
you know, a healthy diet.
Mm-hmm.
So I carry that. I also do a youth fitness program.
Okay.
And then I do...
Is that youth or young at heart? Because, you know, somebody on your casting me out now tell me, say, 15 old. So
I have some 50-year-olds. Okay. I have something for the young at heart.
Okay.
Right? So I do group fitness training. Mm-hmm. I do private training. Mm-hmm. The youth health and fitness program is geared specifically for persons 19 and under.
Okay.
And I have a few kids in there who I'm sure they're approaching 19 and going on to 20, and it seems like they're going to still remain there with me, right?
Uh-huh.
Because obviously it developed more into a mentorship,
right?
And I've watched these kids grow. I've been with them now for a few years.
Okay.
And, you know, so I offer that, and that's offered for kids who are interested in sports, for all sports. I'm not just singling out track and field. I have kids from baseball, swimming, you name it.
Mm-hmm.
But then it's also offered for kids who parents need them to just get out and have a structured health and fitness routine.
Okay.
Okay? So you don't have to be an athlete. The child doesn't have to be an athlete to be involved. That's my youth health and fitness program. That's like my give back program. That's mm-hmm. the one that I hold dear to my heart.
Mm-hmm.
And then obviously I have personal training services and group fitness training services and what's not.
Now, you keep saying group fitness, right? So that means if Juicy Susie them, right?
Correct.
Juicy Susie them waking in the office, where all they just do is cackle by the water fountain.
Correct.
Right? And the most wake out they just get is when they jump conclusions, right?
Correct.
Or run their mouth. That's the learning breath of it.
Correct.
And all they say is, gal, I only want to lose this belly because I ain't fat. That's what they just say.
Right.
I only want to lose this belly because I ain't fat.
Correct.
You got something special for, like, a group of people like that?
Definitely. Definitely.
Okay. Because I want to give away one group session.
Okay.
Okay. That's so the one of our prizes is a group session. So Juicy Susie, y'all, get to the phone line. Okay. All right? That's enough of that standing up by the water cooler all day. Let me see if Andretti be. And how big is the group?
I deal with small groups, especially now within the pandemic.
Is it 4 or 5? What is the number? So that I know what it is we're giving away. Is it a group of 4, group of 5? How do you do the numbers?
Give away a group of 4.
A group of 4. Okay, so
Juicy. Let's start off with 2, because Juicy Susie may not have a group of 4, right? So she may be she or he.
Mm-hmm.
Let's not get ourselves
right,
in trouble today.
Right.
She or he.
Uh-huh. No, I want to give away. Let me tell you what I want to do. I want to give away a group session to some woman them.
Okay.
See, because I tell you what I learned about women, right? And this is why Jesus did go on to the woman them house. Jesus been to Mary house, he been to.
Hold on, let's make this disclaimer. This is your words, not mine.
This is mine.
Okay.
Yeah, this is the gospel of God
and
believe it.
Good.
If you infect a woman, you infect the household.
Okay.
I believe that with everything in me.
Okay.
The reason you eat what you eat, because that's what your wife is cook.
Correct.
The reason you wear the tie you wear is because that's the one your wife picked.
Correct.
If you infect the woman, you can infect the whole house.
Okay.
All right?
Okay.
So I want to get this to Juicy Susie and, I don't know, 3 of her friends.
Yeah, that works.
And boom, and now we infect 12 people because we infect these
Correct.
People. All right.
Correct.
Okay. So that's one of the gifts I've given away. All right. So you got group sessions. You got the young people session, which is 19 and below.
Yes.
And then what do you offer? Let's just say, do you do programs where, let's just say, I have a son. All he does is run around my house all day. I say, this boy must give you an Olympian, you know. I want to begin to train him toward, how do you go about it? What do you do? What do you look for? What's the kind of training you need to be doing? What are some of the things you need to be looking for scholastically as an athlete, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera? Do you offer something like that?
Yes, definitely I do.
So okay.
we could give away a session with that as well.
Okay, very good. You see this? You all stay with me. I can take you all places in life. Let's go to the break, right? Let's go to the break so I can write down what all I get and give for. We giving away 4? We're giving away 4.
It's your day. You tell me how much you want to give away.
See what's happening when you got big time friends that you know for 30 years.
It's your day.
Andretti Bain is my guest, ladies and gentlemen. My phone numbers are 323-622-3253-4316 and 325-4259. You can't mess that up. Give me a call on the next side of the break. I'm leaving Miller. Andretti Bain is in studio. We'll be right back.
The new Guardian Radio app is here. Listen live to all our Guardian Radio shows and live video stream select programs in our studio. Get information about Guardian Radio shows and our hosts. Send messages, including text, email, and even call. All from our amazing new Guardian Radio app. Download it free today in your App Store for your Apple device or Play Store for your Android device. The all-new and improved Guardian Radio app.
find the show interesting? Do you want to be a part of the conversation? Well, sponsor Unleashed today. Call 302-2304 or 302-2375 to see which package is right for you. Join Layvon Miller as he ignites the passion of the next generation by bridging the gap with engaging conversations and innovative ideas. Take action and sponsor Unleashed today at 302-2304 or 302-2375 and be unleashed.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
The part of the hymn I like the most is the one that says, "In pastures green, he leaded me." Man, that's just, when you listen to some of the words of these hymns, you wonder what these people was thinking when they write these 200 years ago. Okay, so here are some of the questions that I have. I want to know, which college did Andretti go to, right? Right? And that is for a personal fitness session with Andretti, right? For the group session, I need you to tell me at least three things that he has competed in and what did he win, right? And that's for Juicy Susie. That question is specifically for Juicy Susie. So Juicy Susie, you and the Juicy Susie gang, that one for y'all. I want y'all to give me three of the things that he's competed in and what did he win at those events. And y'all will get group session, courtesy of Andretti being the Bahamian Dream. And then I have one more question, which is, he has switched his brand from one thing to another thing. Tell me what was the switch and what does he focus on? And Andretti, tell me how do people find you? Your website, your Facebook. Don't call me on the 422 number. That's working for the devil. If you want to call me, 323-623-2323-254-316. 3254259. So tell people, how do they find you in social media and what are your contacts?
Okay. Cell number, business line, 431-6348. And the website is andrettibain.com, andrettibain.com. And then the email is info, at andrettibain.com.
Info@AndrettiBain. And he has a famous name, people, isn't he? He's named after Mario Andretti,
correct,
the famous race car driver. Correct. info@AndrettiBain.com.
Yes.
All right, that's the email. I got the email. I got the website. I got the phone number. And I'm now taking the phone calls for y'all to win some things. Let's see if we could get Juicy Susie on the line, hopefully, because I want her to win this. So I'm going to give her to what I'm giving her. I'm giving her four sets of sessions. So there's the group session, that'll be one set of the sessions. Then there's the personal session, that'll be one set of the session. And then I want you all to tell me, I'll figure out the other questions. Let's take a phone call. Good morning, caller, you're on. Caller, you there? They tired holding it.
Good morning, how you doing?
Morning, how you doing?
Always well, Levin.
Which college did Andretti Bain go to?
Andretti Bain went to ORU.
ORU, what does that stand for?
Hello.
Hi, what does ORU stand for?
Oral Roberts University.
Oral Roberts University. Okay, caller, hold the line for me.
Hey, Levin.
Hey, how you doing?
I already called. You could re-gift the
no problem. I can put it back in the queue. Go ahead.
It's good to know that someone who has been to the top of the world in athletics has turned around and decided to give back. I've seen Andretti climb from the bottom to the top. Mm-hmm. So, well done, Andretti. Keep it up and encourage your others.
I know this voice. Same. I know this voice.
This is Ralph.
I know this voice. Yeah.
Andretti knows the voice as well.
Ralph, I appreciate you, son. Ralph has been there with me every step of the way.
Every step of the way.
From a junior straight into a senior. And Ralph, yeah. I truly appreciate you. And I'm glad I have the opportunity to tell you that on air, that I truly appreciate you and your service to Bahamian Athletics.
No problem. Thanks, sir.
All right. I actually offended now. I asked him which college you've been to. He probably know which preschool you've been to.
You got that right.
323-623-2325-4316-325-4259. I'm going to change that question a little bit. What did Oral Roberts University give to Andretti Bain because of his contribution? So that is the new question. That'll give you one personal training session. Where did Andretti compete and what did he win there? That'll give you that for Juicy Susie. That one is for Juicy Susie and the gang. Juicy Susie and the Juicy Susie gang. And if you could tell me what Andretti Bain's website and email are, I will give you a session with Andretti Bain. And then if you're able to tell me what his phone number is, I'll give you a session with Andretti Bain. All right? So that's four. That's one, two, three, four. And because I like to kick, if you can tell me what all does his online store offer, I'll give you a session. All right? So let's go with that. 323-623-2325-4316-325-4259. You can have personal sessions with Olympian Andretti Bain and his fitness thing that's going on. Let me read a couple of these text messages. This one here says, good morning, Levin. It's sad enough for me as it is. With Reverend Sanders' funeral, now you say you're leaving the Guardian. Only thing left to do is Juan is not leaving. I promise you that. So I am leaving the Guardian. That is happening. Tomorrow will be my final show. All right. Y'all give me a call. Y'all will win my prizes. 323-6232. My phone line's working. 325-4316-325-4259. You can give me a call. Let's give out some of this stuff. Dreddy come all the way from where he come from so we can give out free things. And I want you all to win these things, all right? There's no one on the phone. So if you call now, you should be able to get it. Not even Anton on my phone. Isn't that amazing? Let's see if we can get some calls in. 323-623-2354-316-325-4259. This says, good morning, Levin. I'm as young as Andretti. He and I have been in the same track club. I'm proud and excited about his accomplishments. On another note, seeing that the hip back is in limbo, please consider having your show for 3 hours. Thank you. I think you're very kind, X-Rider, but the sun is about to set on my time here at the Guardian. And, it's been a hell of a ride, 7 years, actually.
You will be missed, Levin.
And I want to say this, for whatever it is worth, I will say this. I came here primarily before I kind of made my daybreak there. My radio daddy, Stephen Hanna, introduced me to radio, right? And then I had a radio mummy, Keyshawn Fowler, who introduced me to bigger radio, which was ZNS. Mm-hmm. And then I ran into a guy by the name of Van Ferguson, VANN in the AM, right?
Yes.
And I have to say this. I do not know of a radio manager that has built a better radio lineup. Like, for whatever it is worth, every single member of that lineup that Van Ferguson had built went on to be marvelous in radio. And so he obviously had an amazing eye for talent and knew what it took to, keep people engaged.
Correct.
And even when our radio station didn't really have good reception all the time, what we had was amazing talk talent.
Correct.
And so definitely that relationship dovetailed into, all of the other things that have happened in my life to this point. Because I will tell you this, 20 years ago, all I wanted to be was a big, bad, biggity, gun-toting soldier. I didn't want to be nothing else in life. That was it. That was the highlight of my life. And I did that, and I was good at it. Oh, go ask the people. I was great at it, actually. And the time came for the sun to set on that. And then my plan was I was going to go and help my daddy because he was aging. Well, still fairly young, but aging.
Right.
And he had poured all his strength into making sure that we were all grown. And now that I was grown and I had some polish on me from the military, I wanted to go back and go help my daddy. He had a ground transportation company. I wanted to go help him build that. I did that. We were able to get new equipment and everything under my management. And then my daddy died, right? And the story is still, continued on in media. And 7 years later, here we are. And now this chapter is about to close.
Right.
But the one thing I have learned, I've said all that to say this, the one thing I've learned about the pages of life is they will continue to turn into an even more brighter, more interesting, more meaningful story. And that is with every turn of the page.
Correct.
And so I look forward to the page turning tomorrow. I will say this, though. I have been given no appointment. Let me emphatically state that on air. Okay. I've been given no appointment, and I imagine that if they were to give me an appointment, I would be Secretary General of Englistan.
Okay.
That is probably the best I would be able to scrape. I don't know, but I don't have an offer on the table, so do not be dismayed. That is not why I'm leaving. It's for personal reasons, and I need to go and deal with some personal things. Okay.
Well, definitely right. Wish you all the best in your future endeavors.
Mm-hmm. So why all the moment, you know something? I think the people then pass the whole fitness. I don't know. They just won't be fat and look bad for the rest of the year.
January over, right?
They just won't be fat and look bad for the rest of the year. Listen, let me help you all. Okay, so it don't have to be Juicy Susie. Anybody could win the group thing, because maybe Juicy Susie didn't want to call. She said, well, I know it's Juicy Susie, right? Give me a call, 323-6232. We're just giving away the things. If you get through to the line, I'm going to give you a session with Andretti Bean. How does that sound? 323-6232, 325-4316, 325-4259. Text right here says, good morning, Mr. Miller. Oh, no. What are we going to do? But all the best to you. You know, keep on the firing line, beloved. Let's take a phone call. Good morning, caller. You're on. Caller, you there? Caller, you there?
Yes, I am.
Hey, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm great. What do you you want to answer a question?
Yes, the email and the website.
Uh-huh.
info@andrettibain.com and andrettibain.com.
Andrettibain.com. All right. So hold the line. My producer will get your name and your number. And you just won yourself a session with Andretti Bain.
Thank you very much.
All right. Let's take another one. 323-6232. Man, and y'all don't understand how big time this is, you know. The man is an Olympian. I mean, do you know what it must cost to have him outside in the heat training with you? Do you know how much money that went into his own personal training? Yeah, so don't take this lightly, right? Like, this ain't back of the bush gym international. This is Andretti Bain. Let's take another one of the phone calls. Good morning, Carly Ron.
Yes, good morning. Is it the Golden Shovel Award?
He did win the Golden Shovel Award. Is that what? Well, I call it that.
Oh, it is okay.
We'll name it the Golden Shovel Award.
The Golden Shovel Award.
Oh,
right?
All right.
But when he got it from ORU, do you remember what it was for?
For the highest achievement in athletics.
For being a groundbreaker in athleticism at ORU. Yes, that is correct. Hold the phone line. You just won yourself a session with Andretti Bain as well, all right? And I got one more for whoever could give me the phone number. My producer, you getting these names and numbers? All right, good. If you could give me Andretti Bain's phone, business phone contact, I'll give you a session with Andretti Bain. 323-6232-325-4316-325-4259. Let's take it. Let's come on and call you on. Call you there? I'm waiting on my producer. Not there? Let's take the next line. Good morning, call you on. They're not there either? Okay. 323-6232-325-4316-325-4259. I do want to give out this group session. I really want to give it to the woman them because I care about the woman them Andretti. It is my favorite pastime.
Mm-hmm.
Caring for the woman them. That is all I ever want to do, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so I want Juicy Susie and three of her friends to win a group session, right? Y'all could go and have fun. You know how y'all is to it. Carry your bottle of soda. Gossip all the way till you get to where you're waking out. Andretti can kill you. And then when you finish, y'all could go in the car and say, Cal. Oh, Jesus, he almost killed me. Oh, girl, my back burning. You know? And you can feel good about yourself, right? You would have...
Sound like you know a lot, Leon.
You know, there was a time I was kind of into fitness, right?
I remember.
Yeah. And
you had the people out there jogging 5 o'clock in the morning.
Listen.
The military training.
Some of the things you hear people say in the minute, oh, my leg could drop off. What do you mean it could drop off? And it hook up to your waist? That could drop off too. So it's always fun. We got phone calls. Let's take a phone call. 323-6232-325-4316-32. I see the phones lighting up. I don't know what's happening. I got 4 minutes. 325-4316-325-4259. You could text me 422-4796. I'm not giving anything to people who text because then they can say I give it to my cousins and I don't want them to say that about me, all right? So I've got the group session left. Andretti Bain is in studio with me. Anything on the horizon, Andretti?
Ah, man, live on so much things in the pipeline,
mm-hmm.
You know, and the biggest thing right now is just really trying to navigate throughout this pandemic.
Sure.
You know, staying safe, keeping my clients safe, definitely integrate all health and fitness safety protocols,
mm-hmm.
sanitizing equipment, small groups, socially distanced groups, doing it all, you know? So so right now, just building the brand, building the brand.
Yeah, that's cool. Let's take a phone call. Good morning, caller. You're on. Caller, you there?
Yeah.
Good morning, caller. You're on. I could hear me in your background, but I can't hear you. You there? Not there. Give me a call back. 323-623-2325-4316-325-4259. Give me a call. I want to give away this group package. I really want to give it to a woman. That's what I really want to do. Because, you know, they say no one treating them fair in life. So I will make sure that they see that I am here being fair to them. Good morning, caller. You're on. Caller, you there? Don't listen to your radio. Listen to me on the phone.
Okay. Hi.
How you doing?
I'm great. How are you?
I'm fine.
Yeah, so let me just tell you. Mm-hmm. It's a group of us at the office that started off with the year. Just, I guess, increasing our steps. Mm-hmm. And I would love to win the package for me and my ladies at the office.
You would love. You think you could try answer one of my questions? You could try?
No. I'm going to be honest. No, I'm sorry.
Oh, okay.
I listen every day. Does that count for anything?
That does count for something. I thank you very much for that.
Yeah, thank you for bringing a smile to my face every day. We're from home.
Wow.
And I love, 11 o'clock brings a smile to my face.
You're so kind. Okay, so let me help you, right? Right?
Mm-hmm.
Right? Andretti phone number is 431-6348.
431-6348.
Uh-huh. Now, what is Andretti Bain's phone number?
431-6348.
Well, see that? And just like that. You and your, and how many of y'all are there?
Six at the office.
Six of y'all, okay. So mm-hmm. So we're going to hold the phone line. My producer's going to take your name and your number. And Andretti Bain will call you and we'll set up a session for you and your girls.
Oh,
see how easy that was?
I'm going to send a group chat right now.
Who do you love on talk radio? Tell the world.
Actually, you know what is your name? I know Sam.
Oh my God. Okay, let me help you. I name Levin Miller. You ready? Let's try it again.
Let's try it again.
You got to wait. Tell the world, who do you love on radio?
Levin Miller. There's nobody else that brings a smile to my face.
Oh, hallelujah.
Dropkick is the one thing I can never forget.
Yeah, how to drop kick?
Thank you for your time on the radio. Absolutely, absolutely enjoyed it.
Appreciate you very much, caller. Text right here says, congratulations to Andretti Bain. He continues to make the SJC class of 2003 very proud. I don't know how come he ended up that far. Because he was supposed to come Prince William. That's where the rest of us had been, Prince William. Me, Cadero, all us was over at Prince William. I don't know what Andretti, him and Kieran was doing over there at St. John's. Y'all was the only two that went that far. I don't know. I know y'all get all the way over there. Let's take this last phone call. Good morning, caller. You're on. You got 10 seconds. Call you there? Is this the same? Okay, good. Perfect. All right, so Dreddy, thank you so much, man, for coming. I appreciate you for giving up the sessions. Give them your phone number one more time and your website one more time, and then let's get out of here.
Phone number 431-6348. Mm-hmm. Website AndrettiBain.com, AndrettiBain.com. And Levon, I just want to thank you again.
Mm-hmm.
And I wish you.